When someone has a heart attack, they often clutch their left arm in pain, but the heart is in the chest, not the arm. So what's up? I'm Cameron, and this is Minute Earth. When we feel pain, it's often because pain receptors in skin sensed that something was wrong, like a cut or a burn. In response, they generate a pain signal that travels to the brain along a chain of three nerve cells. The first cell in the chain generates the signal, then carries it to the spinal column, where it enters through one of the vertebrae. There, it links with a second neuron that carries the signal upward toward the thalamus in the brain, where it links with a third neuron that stimulates a specific region in the brain's sensory cortex. At this point, your brain creates the feeling of pain. The sensory cortex has places for feeling most parts of the body, like hands and feet, with large areas devoted to the most sensitive parts. But little or none of the sensory cortex deals with pain from internal organs. This doesn't mean the organs can't send pain signals anyway. When pain signals from a hurt organ get to the spinal cord, they are often forced to merge onto pain pathways from other, more sensitive body parts. Specifically, pain from an ailing heart often gets funneled onto nerve pathways in the spinal cord that carry sensations from the arm, which in turn light up the part of the brain that senses arm pain. This is why people tend to feel crushing pain in their left arms during a heart attack. Usually, at least. Scientists don't really understand why, but some brains interpret heart pain as coming from the arm, while others interpret it as coming from the jaw. The pain is real, but the brain just doesn't have a good way of knowing exactly where it came from. This signal merging problem doesn't just happen with heart pain. Pain signals from the liver tend to merge onto tracts that end up in pain centers for the neck, and pain from the kidneys can merge onto tracts from the thighs. But much of the time, pain from organs is just felt in nearby skin and muscles due to the way that nerve paths merge. This phenomenon is called referred pain, and it seems to be an unavoidable quirk of the way that nerves are wired. There's still a lot to learn about how the brain interprets organ pain, but the more scientists learn, the better we will get at mapping the tracks of our pain trains.